Hey, Doc Martinez here, and today we will be making a Fuzzy Tauntaun Old-Fashioned from Oga's Cantina at Galaxy's Edge. Sadly, this will be my last Star Wars drink to close out the month of May, which I consider Star Wars month. The Fuzzy Tauntaun is a yellow fruity alcoholic drink served at the Cantina. It is one of their most popular drinks because of the Buzz foam that is put on top of the drink. Yes, Buzz with three Z's. This foam causes a tingling sensation on the lips when consumed. Now, the drink was named after the Tauntaun species from the ice planet Hoth. Now, Tauntauns are a species of snow lizard found roaming the windswept snow plains of Hoth. The Rebel Alliance domesticate the swift creature during their stay on the ice planet and use the animals for patrol duties outside of Echo Base. So the Tauntaun's thick skin helped them adapt and survive the icy conditions on the planet Hoth that few other creatures could. And though Tauntauns are sure-footed and well-equipped to handle Hoth's daytime temperature, the chilling extreme temperatures of Hoth's night could still possibly prove deadly. In the wild, Tauntauns often travel in herds of up to 25 and could actually burrow into the snow for warmth. Their tails help them to keep balance while running, and their herds were led by a female matriarch. Now, the creatures had an odor that was unpleasant to humans due to the layers of fatty blubber that helped them acclimate to the temperatures of Hoth. But it was apparently nothing compared to the smell from the inside of our fresh Tauntaun corpse. Cocktail quiz time! Why did Tauntauns have two sets of nostrils? You gotta stay tuned to find out. This is the quiz you have been looking for. Fun fact, Jabba kept a stuffed Tauntaun head in his palace besides Han Solo, who was frozen in carbonite at the time. Han ventured out in the freezing cold temperatures of the planet Hoth to find his missing friend Luke. And it was Han who sliced open Luke's dead Tauntaun to keep Luke from freezing to death. So the question is, can you really survive a blizzard inside a Tauntaun? In my research, I have found a very interesting article that helped answer this question using science. So I'll leave a link below if you want to read that. So let's get to making a Fuzzy Tauntaun Old Fashioned. Now, it does require a little bit of science and prep time and pre-planning to make. And it also requires a few things not found in every kitchen. Also on another note, Disney has not shared this recipe. So I gathered this recipe and adapted it to fit in Old Fashioned by using a few recipes I found online. I will leave links for those below as well. First, we need to make the Buzz foam. This is the thing that actually sets the drink apart. It requires a little bit of chemistry, and you cannot find all the ingredients at your local grocery store. So advanced planning is key. Now, it's the buzz buttons, sometimes called a toothache plant, that is the special ingredients, and I bought a pack on Amazon to use for this drink. Ingredients for buzz button foam. 1 cup Everclear, about 50 buzz button flowers. Soy, lecithin, 1-2% by weight. Water. Making buzz button foam. First, crush flowers with the back of a spoon the best you can. Then combine Everclear and the flowers in a sealable container. Leave in a dark place for a minimum of 3 weeks or longer. The longer you leave it, the more buzz effect you will get. Greg from howtodrink did a version with a blender, then a rapid infusion technique in case you want to speed up the process. I'll leave a link below. When ready, you want to strain the liquid and measure out as much as you plan to use. Weigh and record the weight. We used 2 ounces, which equaled 63 grams. In a separate container, measure out water by weight, 2 ounces, which equaled 85 grams. Then add the two numbers together. In our case, 63 plus 85 equals 148. We multiply that by 2%. We got 2.96 grams of lecithin. To the water, we added the 1-2% of soy lecithin by weight, We put it in the microwave and heat it in short bursts because it could foam over very quickly. We then completely dissolved the lecithin and combined it with the buzz button that we measured out previously. We stirred and popped into the fridge to cool. When we're ready to use, we will add a fish tank pump and an aerostone to the liquid and watch as it bubbles. Ideally, you want to give the foam at least a minute to set up before scooping on your drink. Well, this shouldn't be a problem because next, let's make the drink. Fuzzy Tauntaun Old-Fashioned Ingredients. Simply orange juice with tangerine, or substitute simply orange juice with fresh squeezed tangerine / mandarin juice. Ciroc peach vodka, simple syrup, peach schnapps, fresh squeezed lemon juice, lemon bitters, orange bitters, optional edible glitter, and buzz button. Now, let's make the Fuzzy Tauntaun Old Fashioned. We are going to combine the ingredients in a cocktail shaker filled with ice. So first we'll add 4 ounces of simply orange juice and then 2 ounces of mandarin fresh squeezed juice. Then add 1.5 ounces of Ciroc peach vodka with 0.5 ounces of peach schnapps. Next, add 1.5 ounces of simple syrup and 0.5 ounces of fresh squeezed lemon juice. Next, we'll be adding 2 dashes of lemon bitters and 2 dashes of orange bitters. Optional, add a little bit of edible glitter. Now, we'll shake vigorously for 20 or 30 seconds and strain into a glass with ice. Now the fun part. At the top, we'll add the buzz button foam. Cocktail quiz time. Why did Tauntauns have 2 nostrils? Answer, the large set was used for maximum oxygen intake during intense physical activity, while the small set was used during inactive periods in grazing to keep out the snow and cold. All right, so here we are with the Fuzzy Tauntaun Old Fashioned. The big difference between the Fuzzy Tauntaun that you get at Disney or Disney World at the Cantina is they don't use bitters. But in order for it to be an Old Fashioned, I did have to add bitters, and that's why I have the bitters in there. But the drink looks pretty much the same, so I'm excited to taste this. I have been able to have it while at the park, so I know what it tastes like. So I'm pretty excited to try tasting this one. I actually haven't tasted this one yet. My family has, so I had to make quite a few of these, which is kind of funny because I'm getting the last of the foam. But as you can see, the foam's actually holding up very well. So very excited about that as well. So here we go. The Fuzzy Tauntaun Old Fashioned. My last Star Wars drink for this year, 2022 for May. Let's try this. Perfect. Very, very fruity drink. Very sweet. So if you like sweet drinks, you're gonna love this one. And now there it goes. Now I start feeling the tingling, a little bit of tingling on the tip of my tongue, and just a tiny bit in the lips right now. I know when my family was trying it, they were saying that it took a moment for that tingling to get in. I'm actually anxious to try Greg's version of it in how we drink, and seeing if doing the rapid infusion will actually have the same effect or even a better effect. So one of those things I'm definitely gonna have to try. But it really does. It does taste like the one from Galaxy's Edge. So if you don't make it out to Galaxy's Edge, you can make one at home now. So thank you again for traveling with me down my old fashioned rabbit hole. Funny thing, my lips are tingling even more now. Before I forget, the one thing I didn't show you, I'm showing you the front side of the glass, but if you look on the back side of the glass, you can see that little bit of glitter. Just add a little bit of fun to it. Makes it a little bit more of a galaxy drink, you know? So once again, if you like this video, please click on the next one, subscribe, and may the force be with you. Cheers.